And there you have it. The second debate is over, and it was a rocket ride fueled by adrenaline. And you are telling us so much more. You are writing us about the fire in that room, and George, about the tension, the aggression a lot of people were saying in their emails to us. I want to put a picture up there in the corner. There you see what everybody thinks is a picture that sums it up, New York Times photo tonight, how they were dealing with each other in that room.
That is the story of the night. Both candidates decided they were going to rouse partisans tonight, rouse their supporters, not worry so much about those uncommitted voters, maybe many of them in the room who might squirm when they see that kind of tension as the candidates go at each other. But Diane, what you saw tonight, and look at that closing statement that President Obama just gave, talking about the 47% comment of Mitt Romney. That was the answer a lot of Democrats were expecting in the first question to the first debate. And you saw from the start of this debate tonight that President Obama brought the debate the Democrats needed to see from him. He unloaded on Mitt Romney on just about every single issue. Romney did manage to hold his own, especially when he was talking about President Obama's record, when he addressed the questioners directly. But I think that he ended up getting into some trouble when he was arguing with the moderator. And what could be the moment of the night, Diane, is the exchange on Libya, where Governor Romney said that President Obama did not refer to an act of terror the day after the attack, when in fact he said he did, and he was backed up by Candy Crowley, the moderator.
All right. As always, let us go to our Matthew Dowd, who has advised presidential campaigns over two decades. Lay it on the line, Matt. Was there a clear victor?
Yeah, very clear victor. President Obama gets the victory in this. Not as overwhelming as Mitt Romney, but he gets a victory. And I don't want to mix a lot of sports metaphors, but this was a heavyweight fight. President Obama dropped the rope-a-dope strategy from 2 weeks ago and came out swinging, jab, jab, jab. He didn't knock him out, but he won on points. And that loss that he lost, the points that he lost over the last, since his performance last time, he's going to gain some of those back. Clear victory for President Obama.
Nicolle, Wallace?
I disagree a little bit. I think that Romney had one strategic goal tonight. He had to speak directly to the people, to the voters who voted for Obama last time, but they're unhappy with the pace of recovery. And I didn't think he took as clear of a line to those voters as he could have and as he did 2 weeks ago. But there's a big difference. Tonight he had an opponent in Barack Obama.
And there's Nicolle Wallace from the Republican side. How about Donna, Brazile for the Democrats?
Well, I'm smiling because I think President Obama came tonight to play ball. He not only took the game to Mitt Romney, he had concise answers, he was feisty, he was in command of the issues, the facts, and from a stylistic point of view, he stood up and he approached not only the person who asked the question, but he was able to respond to Mitt Romney with the things that he didn't do a week ago.
So George, Will, round us out here. Was President Obama the winner tonight?
We're having a little trouble hearing George, and we hate not to hear George.
We will get back to him as soon as we can.
We will certainly get right back to
him. But let me go to Jake Tapper in the room right now. We heard that the Obama team was out in force spinning before the debate was even over.
That's right. And one suspects that they were going to say President Obama won this no matter what. But they are, I think, even some Democrats not affiliated with the campaign, very happy about the president's performance, saying he was aggressive, he was firm. Maybe he started out a little shaky at the beginning, a little too eager perhaps to mix it up with Mitt Romney. But by the end, Democrats say, people on the Obama campaign say, this is the president that the Americans, people who like President Obama, know, assertive, aggressive, and many of them citing that Benghazi back and forth, George, that you alluded to, saying that Mitt Romney was wrong. President Obama did use the term acts of terror in his remarks the day after that what happened in Benghazi, George.
Yes, one of the first tweets we got, by the way, Jake, was someone saying, hey, President Obama woke up. And let's go now to David Muir, who's been covering the Romney campaign. What are they saying to you?
Really fascinating, Diane, to watch this in the hall here tonight. Governor Romney coming out at first, employing sort of a new strategy, trying to connect, talking to that student who asked that question, calling him by name, Jeremy, asking him when he would graduate, taking an interest in him. But I got to tell you, this was quickly overshadowed by the tension inside this town hall. These are two men who appeared not to like each other very much. That was very evident inside that room. What the Romney campaign is saying tonight is that the president was too strident, that he was too negative against Mitt Romney. In fact, this struck me. They said he raised the volume of his voice but didn't improve the value of his argument. But I've got to tell you, that moment in the room with that Libya question that Jake Tapper brought up and George mentioned a moment ago was palpable. The room went silent, and then the applause. And also on the pension, you could tell that the governor had worked on that pension line, asking the president if he looks at his own pension. But the president turning that around and the governor saying, I don't look at mine. Yours is much bigger. So that'll be a fodder for tomorrow as well.
We want to go straight to George Will. Our communications are back up right now. And the big question, George, was there a winner, and how much did it change things?
The voters will tell us. I think there was a winner in the sense that Barack Obama not only gained ground that he had lost, but he cauterized some wounds that he inflicted on himself by seeming too diffident and disengaged. Both men tonight, I think, tiptoed right up to the point of rudeness, but stepped back. It was a very good fight. I have seen every presidential debate in American history since the four of Nixon and Kennedy in 1960. This was immeasurably the best. And I think the president's tactical victory was on trying to get Mitt Romney to unring a bell, which he is very hard to do. First was on self-deportation and immigration. Mitt Romney probably gained some ground with Hispanics by stressing something about which they're very unhappy, the president's failure to come up with immigration reform. But the self-deportation phrase that the president, Mitt Romney used during the primaries is hard to get out from under. And the president held his fire on the 47% until he had the last word in the debate. That is, he used it in his summation in a way that Mitt Romney could not explain or respond to. So I think as a tactical measure tonight, the president did very well indeed.
So we have one absolute, the best debate. Mm-hmm. George Will has seen. So many of you noticed we're fact-checking some of the events in the debate tonight from home, and our own Jonathan Carl is standing by at our fact-check desk to examine some of the most inflamed disagreements tonight. John.
And Diane, one of the big ones was that issue of the Detroit auto bailout. One of the real flashpoints in this debate is when Governor Romney said to the president, you say I let Detroit go bankrupt, but you let Detroit go bankrupt. You, he said, took Detroit into bankruptcy. And he said, that is precisely what I wanted, and that's what ultimately happened. But, Diane, there's a little bit of a half-truth here. It is true that under President Obama's plan, Chrysler and General Motors did go through Chapter 11 bankruptcy. It was a managed bankruptcy. But they did it with $80 billion of federal money. That was the bailout in the auto bailout, and that is something that Romney opposed. He thought that money should come from the private sector, and many experts said there just wasn't money in the private sector for the auto industry at that point. And then there was this one. I think this was actually the most heated exchange in the debate. It was on the question of oil and natural gas drilling on public lands. Take a listen.
The day after the attack, Governor, I stood in the Rose Garden, and I told the American people and the world that we are going to find out exactly what happened, that this was an act of terror, and I also said that we're going to hunt down those who committed this crime.
Well, that was not the oil and gas exchange. That was obviously the Benghazi exchange. And by the way, on that, Diane, the president did that day in the Rose Garden actually say, no acts of terror will ever shake the resolve of this great nation, talking about what happened there. But it was another 2 weeks before he referred to that attack as a terrorist attack. But on this issue of oil and gas drilling, Governor Romney said that oil and gas drilling is down by 50% on public lands. That is not exactly true, but it's not far off. In fact, we looked at the numbers, and oil drilling permits on public land dropped by 37% in the first 2 years of the Obama administration, 42% in terms of leases for natural gas. So the numbers weren't exactly right, but it is true that that those drilling leases and permits are down under President Obama.
Okay, Diane. Looking at it all, John Carl, I want to bring in Matthew Dowd again, because we noticed the final time count. According to one calculation, President Obama had more time tonight, 44 minutes versus Governor Romney's 40 minutes. First of all, what do you think of that, and how is this going to change in the next few days?
Well, first, I think voters and the 60, 70 million people watching it are not going to come away with the impression. They're going to come away with the impression that both these candidates had plenty of time to talk about what they wanted. I think what this may lead to is a bunch of conservatives and Republicans attacking Candy Crowley. And when that happens, that is a sure sign that President Obama won this. When you start attacking the ref or start attacking the umpire, it means you left a lot of plays on the field. And if, when you see that, you know they lost.
You already are seeing it. Ed Gillespie from the Romney campaign, Sandy Crowley was wrong when she called out Mitt Romney on that. But Nicolle, I wonder on this question of how much has changed. It does seem that President Obama at least built a firewall tonight, coming off of that first debate.
Yeah, I mean, I think that'll probably be the conclusion. But Republicans can walk and talk and chew gum. I might not be able to right now, but we can make the point that Romney did what he needed to do. And I don't think it's clear tonight that undecided voters, as few as there are going to be pleased with Obama's anger, his visceral attacks on Romney. And I think what Romney has done the whole time, going back to the primary, is to put one foot in front of the other and to make his case methodically. He did not fail to do that tonight. He succeeded. And really, the big stark difference is that he had someone to debate tonight. So I think that the Romney campaign will be able to make these points about Candy. It's a fact that he had less time. It's a fact that the room was stacked against him. And it's a fact that Candy played a more activist role than I think anybody expected.
When Republicans lose debate, they always find something wrong with the moderator, the referee. The point is that Mitt Romney was not on his game. He didn't understand his positions. President Obama understood his positions as well as Mitt Romney's previous positions. So tonight, Obama won because he was able to answer Mitt Romney and all of those, all of the things he said 2 weeks ago.
You heard George Will call it the best presidential debate ever. Diane, it certainly was the most fierce.
And 67 million people watched the first one. We'll let you know about this one. Thank you for joining us.